Was it a better throw or a better catch?
Before I get to that, Skip, you deserve to lose. If you allow a team to go 75 yards in 30 seconds, you probably deserve to lose that game regardless of what transpired the last play. But given the last play and the heroics that happened between Kyler Murray and DeAndre Hopkins, Skip, I'm going to say the catch. Because normally what they do in the Hail Mary, and it's hard to say this was a Hail Mary, is that you only go to that single receiver side if he's single coverage. Because normally when you go trip side, three receiver, Skip, they load everybody there, know you're trying to get the tip or the carom. But DeAndre Hopkins had three guys on him. There was no reason other than the fact that he's DeAndre Hopkins for Kyler Murray to throw this ball. But Kyler did a great job of buying time, and that's what he's able to do, Skip, with those legs of his. Get out of harm's way, spin out, and throw the ball down the field. And DeAndre Hopkins, Skip, how he was able to. Okay, he high-pointed the ball. Okay, that's one thing. Now you got to bring the ball down. You got three guys around you. They're clutching at you. They're pulling at you. But this goes to show you, Skip, if you do what you're supposed to do. See, everybody's trying to be a hero in Buffalo. I picked off Kyler Murray the last play. What are you supposed to do, Skip, on that play right there? Knock it down. Now, also, Sean McDermott, take a timeout because a field goal doesn't do anything for you. Take a timeout to make sure your defense is set. Okay, guys, this is the way we're going to play it. He did nothing. Why? Why would you go home with those two timeouts? Now, you know they don't transfer over. You don't get five timeouts the first half next week. That doesn't happen. DeAndre Hopkins made an unbelievable play. I thought the Buffalo Bills did a great job, Skip, up until that point containing him. They did a great job up until that point containing Kyler Murray. They had picked him off, Skip. They had sacked him three times, and he just had a little over 200 yards passing the football. Didn't matter. For 59 minutes and 30 seconds, Skip, you did an unbelievable job. But the job was not complete. It's just like anything. It doesn't matter what you do until the beginning. Like, well, you got to get the rebound. We get the rebound, we got a shot. And we've seen teams miss the shot, and the team gets the rebound back, and then all that's out the window. I'm going to say DeAndre Hopkins because I've seen a guy make these throws, several of these throws on the Hail Mary before. Mr. Hail Mary himself, Aaron Rodgers. But for them to be able to do this, this is big for the Cardinals, Skip. And what it did, what it's done, is that Kyler Murray's running down there and he just pole vaulted himself into the MVP conversation, Skip. Maybe there were people having the conversation and he overheard them talking about the MVP. But guess what? He's actually in the conversation right now as we speak. Deservedly so, but I'm going to say the catch because that was unbelievable over three people.
Okay. My turn. The catch was great, but the throw was greater because the throw on degree of difficulty was three times the degree of difficulty of the catch. So let's break it back down. So Kyler bolts to his left, which is for a right-handed quarterback the wrong way to be bolting because you're going to have to throw it across your body. And the first thing he has to do is he has to escape Mario Addison there for a second who got him around the ankles. No big deal, but you have to flinch for a second and take your eyes off what all your receivers are doing. Then as he runs and accelerates to his left, here comes big old Ed Oliver, who's 6'1", you know, 300 pounds, looming right in his face. And Kyler at 5'9", we'll give him 5'10". He throws this ball falling sideways out of bounds against his body, across his body, and manages to get enough velocity on it to get it 55 yards in the air. But more important, he manages to drop it right into the apogee of DeAndre Hopkins' leap, meaning he high points it because the ball was high pointable. Right. It was a perfect throw to a perfect spot against three of the... I don't know that you could find three better in concert DBs than those three. In combination, if you look at Jordan Poyer, who's been playing for a long time, and Micah Hyde's one of the better safeties in the game, and Tre'Davious White is definitely one of the better corners. Yep. I couldn't pick three with more savvy and experience to defend that ball than those three, okay? So... But what happens at this point, the pass is so perfect that DeAndre does what he should have done. Okay, let's look at their heights. Jordan Poyer and Micah Hyde are both 6 feet tall, and Tre'Davious is 5'11". Well, DeAndre is 6'1", so he's got an inch and 2 inches on Tre'Davious. Right. So he's got a little bit of a height advantage. Now let's go back to the combine and let's look at their verticals. Mm-hmm. Okay, DeAndre's vertical was 36 inches. It's jumping out of the gym. And you look at Poyer, he was 30 and a half, and Micah was 33, and Tre'Davious was 32. So on leaping ability, he's 3 inches clear on vertical of all three of them from their combine numbers, right, which weren't that long ago. And the point is, who's got the best hands of those four players? Well, obviously, it's what DeAndre does for a living, right, is he catches footballs.
Right.
How many of those kinds of catches has he made in his life from Deshaun Watson? Dozens, hundreds. It's what he does.
Well, I think the thing is, Skip, is that it's not so much how often he catches the ball, because we know he has exceptional hands. It's the moment. Because mm-hmm. we've seen guys have moments where they don't catch the ball, and they're used to, and they always catch, like, man, he never dropped those, but he dropped that one. And Skip, for him to hang in the air, think about it now, this is not a 10-yard pass where the ball is going to be right there on you. He has to time that jump perfectly, mm-hmm. or he's going to be coming down, or he's going to be going up too soon. So everything has to be perfect from that distance.
Okay, I got it. But that's what he does best versus what they do best. Then in the end, if we could see it one more time, he gets an assist from Jordan Poyer, because Poyer crashes in to Tre'Davious White, and
he knocks him
sideways and effectively knocks his hands a little bit off the football.
Yes.
Right? Just
yes.
a little bit off the football. I'm not saying that he would have snatched it if he had had the clean shot at it, but I think it's an assist for
Poyer. Well, if he'd had the hand, if he'd took Poyer and took the hand warmer pack off, he'd have got there sooner. First of all, that lets me know he was out of position,
yep.
because he should have never have to come from that distance in order to make that play, Skip. Like I said, if Sean McDermott should have, because I've been on teams where we call a timeout to make sure, Skip, everybody is perfect. Everybody understands their assignment. Knock the ball down. Why are they trying to intercept the ball, Skip? Some of the best advice, Skip, in my 14 years, and I had some coaches along the way, high school from William Hall to Bill Davis, my college coach, Mike Shanahan gave me some of the best advice that any coach has ever given me, Skip. Opening my first game I played for him as a head coach in 95, I had one of the five best days at the time receiving. I had 10 for a buck 80, and he called me to his office, and he showed me some plays, Skip, that I wasn't doing what I was supposed to do. And he looked me dead in my eye and he said, 84, I'll never accept in a win what I wouldn't in a loss.
Okay.
You see, if you knock the ball down, now we saw Jacksonville.
But who has a chance to knock it down? He has posted up Micah Hyde and he has boxed
position.
Him out. Micah Hyde has no chance to knock this ball down.
Poor, you're running,
okay.
coming from.
Okay, all right. But I don't know who has a chance to knock it down, because it's a perfect pass. It's apogee. It's high point. It's just where DeAndre can get his mitts on the football, and I don't know who can knock it down. Nobody has a clear shot at just running, jumping, knocking it down. It wasn't like, oh, anybody could have knocked that down, and you let it slip through your clutches, and he caught it through a sea of hands. Well, his hands are the best hands. They're
yes.
above, because he's out jumping the other three, because that's what he does best.
Well, somebody got that, like, somebody, I don't know who, that looks like a Tre'Davious White hand with the Adidas gloves on.
Yep.
And he's got a little bit of it, but it's too late.
Okay,
because
it's
the ball
too late
is perfect.
To knock it down. Okay, I could argue on their behalf that one of them should be savvy enough just to foul him, because they don't usually throw a flag.
No.
So you could just, like Micah Hyde could have grabbed him or pulled him or bashed him in the back, done something, but he just, look at Micah Hyde, he just tries to play clean ball.
Right.
You know, he's just trying
right.
to tip the ball out of his hands.
Right.
And it did not work.
At the snap of the ball, Skip, if you look at it, they're in a trips right formation. DeAndre Hopkins is the single receiver on the backside. After two steps, Larry Fitzgerald is starting to run towards DeAndre Hopkins. So that should tell you right now, Skip, where is the ball going? If you had to guess, is it going to go towards DeAndre Hopkins and Larry Fitzgerald, or is it going to go to Christian McCurt and Anthony Isabella?
Okay. Some coordinators prefer to jam that receiver at the line of scrimmage,
yes.
because it's so far. It's 43 yards
right.
to the end zone that if you jam him, then he's not going to have time before you can get to Kyler. He's not going to have time to get to the end zone.
Right.
If you pull that off, if you try that defense, You better be clean right. with it. You better nail him because if he escapes.
Normally, Skip, what they would do is that they draft, if it's a trip receiver side, they'll draft the middle receiver because mm-hmm. he's normally the jumper or the tipper. So somebody's mm-hmm. going to try to go lag behind, tip the ball behind, the guy catches, tipped it forward, the guy that's on the inside, which would have been Larry Fitzgerald, he catches. And the guy on the outside, he would go behind.
Okay.
So since there were three receivers and nobody jammed, now we go into the single
okay.
receiver
so
side.
They let DeAndre run free to the end zone.
Yes.
Because they just said, we're going to play straight prevent, and my best DBs are going to be waiting for your Hail Murray, in this case, as right. they're calling it. They're going to be waiting in the end zone for your throw. And they were. They were all in good position to defend the ball, but nobody could because it was a perfect throw, falling sideways across body out of bounds by the little man who I keep telling you since his days at Oklahoma is a magic little man.
Sometimes things are just meant to be. And maybe it was a situation that, Skip, this was meant to be. But for DeAndre Hopkins to go, Skip, it's not, people don't understand how hard it is to time a jump from a ball that's that far away. Because it has to be mm-hmm. perfect. Skip, hey, first of all, you're not going to hang up there. I know in slow motion, look like he hung up there forever. But that's real time. That he has to mm-hmm. time that jump and says, okay, now is the time for me to jump. And if you look at it, they're starting to come down slightly, and he's still up and he's able to hop, but okay. to get it to his body without them knocking it out or him crashing to the ground and it not popping out. We've seen guys catch a ball at his apex, and when they hit the ground, what happened?
Bloop. Okay. But it wasn't like Kyler had a clean pocket because they rushed three against five blockers.
Right.
And it wasn't like Kyler at 5'10"-ish.
Right.
Got a running start to heave this ball. He threw it falling sideways the wrong way across his body out of bounds. Have you ever seen? You're giving him no credit.
Yeah, I'm
for
giving
that.
Credit. Yeah,
I mean, it's unbelievable. It's magical.
Skip, I just saw this. I saw this 3 years ago. Hey, Jim, can we cue that tape? I got a little tape I wanted the people to see because Skip wanted to make you believe nobody's ever done this. Oh my goodness, look at this. He spins. How far did he throw it? 66.
Yep.
In the air. Boom, boom.
Yep. Pretty low.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah. Now he's rolling away, falling away. He throws it 65 mm-hmm. yards in the air.
Yep.
And boom.
Okay. So degree of difficulty, which was harder, that or Kyler's?
And
how about Kyler's?
Skip.
How about Kyler's?
Skip, look where he throws this ball
You know
from.
What? I don't even care about that guy. He that's the guy who stunk it up yesterday at Lambeau Field and almost lost to the Jaguars.
Skip, look
we
at
don't
this.
Care. We don't
Skip,
care about this.
Your guy got a running start.
Oh, stop. My guy got a running start sideways?
Skip.
You know, I'm offended you even showed that. I'm serious. I'm offended. You're trying to take something away from as magical a throw to win a game as we have ever seen.
No.
To escape a sack and throw it sideways, whipping your right leg across your body?
No.
Are you kidding me? And you gave me Aaron bleeping Rodgers throw?
Because I wanted to show
you. He tried to throw it as high as he could. It was pure luck. He didn't even know who he was throwing it to.
He threw it almost 70 yards. In the air.
He tried to hit the ceiling.
That's what Skip, you know that's what he does. He wants to turn the ball over so it comes down. Look at this, Skip.
Yeah.
Do you realize how far that is?
You know what? That was a better catch than a throw because Jeff Janis, wasn't that Jeff Janis?
That was Jeff Janis.
Yeah, way to go, Jeff. Where are you now? Way to go. And where's Patrick?
That's Pat
Peterson on that.
Skip, look how far he throws this ball. He rolls. Look at it. That's 55 to 55.
So what does that have to do with what just happened?
Skip.
Nothing.
No.
Nothing.
Because
so I want our audience to understand this man is trying to discount what Kyler Murray did because he's trying to argue it was a better catch.
No.
With video from how many years ago
three.
Was that? Was it three? It seemed like it was 8 years ago.
But my only point for showing the video is because you made it seem like
I want to drive home the point that Aaron Rodgers yesterday at Lambeau Field had a QBR of 45 on a scale of 0 to 100 against the 31st-ranked defense in the National Football League. I want everybody out there to know that my man brought him up, and so I'm going to rub this point in that Aaron Rodgers actually took a step back out of the MVP race yesterday, stinking it up at home against the Jaguars, trailing for much of the game and barely pulling it out 24-20. Way to go, Aaron, and thank you, Shannon, for that opening. I appreciate it.
So I won't skip. I want you guys people at home because I don't know if you had an opportunity to watch the game yesterday, but Aaron Rodgers was 24-34 for 325.
QBR 45 because he stunk for much of the game.
What about the
empty calories?
I tell you what. where does Dub fall after QBR? Mm. It probably came later because that's what we got.
I've been telling you about Kyler Murray since his first couple of games at the University of Oklahoma. He was magical twice against their arch rival Texas that year. Mm-hmm. He was magical on a Friday night. I think the game was on Fox, as I recall, at West Virginia. Look it up and see what he did on third down again and again and again.
Yes.
And then against a much better Alabama team, a great defensive team, St. Nick's defense in the national semifinal. He had a combined 417 yards against Alabama, and that's without his best deep threat receiver, Hollywood Brown, who could not go. He tried to limp that night and couldn't go.
Skip's goal, 28-0. Skip, yep. I'm not trying to take anything because it was a hard play. He did a great job of being able to buy some time. So the wherewithal for him is that when, and that's the difficult part about playing this kid, Skip, is that how do we press him without running past him and having him jump out the window and take off on us.
Yep.
So that's very difficult because you have to always be on your best behavior, Skip, because you see they get in the red zone, they run the zone read, and every time you see it, he's jumping, and he got one ball in his hand, and he's in the end zone.
Yep.
So that's what makes him so difficult. And once you let him get outside and buy that just that little extra time, that was all he needed. No, the throw was unbelievable, but I had to choose between one or the other. Mm-hmm. And so I'm going to take the catch because without that catch, Skip, he could have made that throw. But what happens if DeAndre Hopkins doesn't catch it? Just like, oh, look, you said the one Tom Brady, I give you a prime example, mm-hmm. in the Super Bowl. The Hail Mary to Gronk, you said after Brandon Graham had pulled away, he broke away, he threw a perfect pass. Mm-hmm. But what happened?
Gronk didn't come down with it.
See?
I don't know if they were pulling on him, tugging on him, or what. But Gronk has to come down with that ball because it hit him right at his high point. But does he have as good a hands as DeAndre Hopkins? Obviously not. Is he the leaper that DeAndre is? Obviously not.
Skip, even if he's not leaping, Skip, he's already 6'6", so he just sticks his hand up. He's probably going to be the equivalent of D-Hop. But it was an unbelievable play. Mm-hmm. This and coming on, they got a short week this week. I think they go to Seattle, Skip.
Thursday night.
So they got a lot of confidence going into this game.
Mm-hmm. And he's already won twice at Seattle. Mm-hmm. He's already beaten them twice. Not once at Seattle at the end of last year, and he beat them at home.
Right.
So now he's going to Seattle, and he's 2-1 against Seattle already in his brief career.
Right.
And his best really, four games he's played so far have come two against San Francisco, one against Seattle, and then that one yesterday against a very good Buffalo team. And by the way, there was no way they should have won this game. Because 34 seconds left, Josh Allen, who should be in the MVP race, he just throws a rocket to Diggs. And I thought, oh, well, that's that. They're up four, and there's no way.
Skip, I said the exact same thing. As a matter of fact, I started fixing my dog's food.
Yep.
And I was like, hey, this thing over. He ain't finna go no 75 yards or no 30 seconds and win the game. And then, Skip, I come back, and I'm looking around, and they celebrating. I'm like, what y'all celebrating for?
Yep.
I'm like,
there you go.
Buffalo.
Think about this. Kyler Murray has already tied the record for games with a touchdown pass and a rushing touchdown in a season of eight games.
That's
only through nine.
Yes.
He's got seven to go to break the record, and I think it's pretty likely he's going to break the record.
Yeah, he's going to be way up there. And because of his leg, Skip, because you're so afraid, because guys like Kyler, Skip, you want them to make quick decisions. But at what expense am I going to make him make this quick decision? Because if I miss him, Skip, that's 30, 40, easy.
Mm. Yep.
So so he's going to keep people on their heels. He's not like, if I run 25 and I run by Tom Brady, he ain't going nowhere. Nope. You run past that kid, and he probably going to hit his head on the goalpost for a touchdown.
Yep. As I said when he was at Oklahoma, quickest feet I've seen since Barry Sanders, who played at Oklahoma State.
But you saw that throw by A-Rod? Jenny, that was 70 yards in there.
We're talking about Kyler Murray and his potential. And I can confirm, you're right, Skip. Watching him on the sideline, it's speed that you can't explain. I mean, he just moves in a way that's so smooth and so efficient. And I love Kyler right now. I'm here for it, guys. Thank you for watching. You can subscribe here to get the latest from the show. And be sure to check out more of the best clips from Undisputed or go watch a few other segments from our other shows on FS1.